リバティウォークプレイリストへようこそ。加藤渡です。この日本からこのゲームでしか楽しめない素晴らしい体験を送ります。30年以上も世界中の車をリバティウォークスタイルでカスタムしてきました。みんなが驚き喜ぶ LB カスタムカーで日本の伝統を大切にしながら作っています。その作品をこのモーターフェストならではの体験を通じてチェックしてみてください。リバティオークの世界を旅して君がトップのその旅を終えることができたなら、僕のコレクションから特別な車をプレゼントするよ。
I'm a customizer. That's all I needed to know. My country is the mecca of tuning. There's lots of things to say. But let's start with this. In Japan, every Custo lover knows the name Wataru Kato. Bringing his own style to bear on supercars, that's his thing.Signature unmistakable. I'm done talking. Just show me what the car can do. you can handle what follows. Magazines, the kind of style that leaves a mark on a kid. In the 90s, only a few tuners like Kato were customizing European and American cars like that. Aggressive and radical. Liberty Walk has three pillars with three distinct styles. Here we're going through the works part, Kato's original touch. Classic Japanese craft based on wide fenders applied to the most beautiful exotic vehicles. The other pillars are nation and performance, but let's leave them for later. Style update on your BMW. Let's see. Boosted turbo, tougher chassis, more powerful brakes, and wider tires. Yeah, these guys are good. Don't be shy now, set it free. We'll be right back. this. Looks like we've got a Color Me Run kind of vibe going on here. Back to basics for the last works race. A Nissan GTR with an insane body kit. Careful with that car. Sozoku? A bad boy thing, and clearly the inspiration here. Back in the 70s, Japanese clans loved to make noise and showcase their styles in illegal races. Those cars, it was crazy. Kato knows his classics. Respect the craft. Now Sozoku is mostly about oversized body kits. It's meant to be impressive. Are a classic of the Japanese car culture. Aggressive by design, but as soon as they pass through Kato's hands, they become insane bangers. Come on now, finish that race. To see at custom shows, huh? Trust me, I know my business. All tuning masterpieces. That's what Liberty Walk, culmination. Doesn't matter if it's a supercar or a sedan, these guys can dress anything up. They want to make their look universal. And believe me, they're getting there. Wide bodies have been dropped for slightly smaller ones, but I still can't see the gap between the side skirts and the ground. Let's hope there are no speed bumps in this race. Chrysler SRT8 is meaner than the regular 300. With a V8 Hemi under the hood, you're more than a basic luxury sedan. That's it. See you on the finish line. City cars, if they look like this. When I tell you that these guys can custom anything. You can do better than this. The sand. It will take more to spoil that paint. Minis are fashion objects. Renowned designers have worked on this car, always respecting its British style. But a little Japanese touch doesn't hurt, right? Play with the camera. See for yourself. Thank you. to get into custom cars, my advice, keep an open mind. Look, you're driving a European car. Lots of different Euro styles. Look them up. My personal favorite is the German look, lowered to the max, bodywork removed, small diameter rims with a large offset. It's a stark style that stays faithful to the original, kind of similar to what we have here today. Driving a C63 AMG, and Mercedes are a hassle to modify. You want to keep their elegance, but add a little urban style. It's like making your grandpa wear a hat backwards. Delicate. Change a thing. Maybe the wheels. I like them more imposing. We'll be right back. check out the Motorfest Custom Show, and I gotta say, you festival goers have some imagination. You've learned a lot, so no holding back. Next Custom Show, you need to show it off. Now show me some proper moves. Step, Liberty Performance. Nobody dared to think about it. Nobody except Kato. He took the car, kitted it out, customized it with his own style, and changed the game. Now everyone wants to modify their more exotic rides. Show them who's the top dog. Wow, take it easy. Keywords now are supercars and performance. The look is more subdued, keeps things effective, and retains the original spirit of the car. NSX has a hybrid powertrain. Add all the hubby custom you want. Its speed will still be lethal. Liberty Walks sells body kits for this car. They even make one for the 92 Honda NSX. Remember Shingo? He always wanted to get one of these. Do your job now. Push that engine. Crazy about that car. Different approach with their performance line. Top end vehicle, different treatment. Light tuning, nothing too distorting. Front and side diffusers that widen the body while blending with the lines. All sublimated by some first of colors. I'm usually into buff street mods, but man, this is a beautiful job. I respect that. Guts. Kind of fitting considering the Aventador was upgraded several times by Lamborghini itself. Units in the world. Of those, maybe 10 custom by Liberty Walk. Tops. So you better drive clean. I can fix a couple of scratches, but ruin the car and you'll be dealing with the Motorfest PR. Hirschy's part of some biker gang. Think you can stay first till the end? faster next. So I hope you've had your breakfast. Not messing with you. You just signed up for a race that goes around the whole island, the full loop, during which you'll be driving three cars, one after another, one for each Liberty line. As you can see, it starts with Liberty Nation, with the return of the Mini Cooper. Focus. So stop listening to me and get into it. Hey, how are you holding up? You're about to switch to Liberty Works. Expect a more buff ride and some extra speed. Coming right up. Careful for the swamp. There you go. Back with the BMW M4 Liberty Walk Edition. My firm favorite of the day. Moving to second gear. Go kill it. last swap is only seconds away. You know what that means, right? Third gear. Hold on to your seat. Back on the Liberty Performance side. With the fastest customized car of this whole Liberty Walk experience, the Huracan Performante by Liberty Performance. You get in sync and finish this. after all. Looks like it wasn't just a fluke.